Hello viewers, welcome to your favorite channel Rising Legal. Today in this banking law class, I am going to discuss an important topic, that is debt recovery tribunal. Viewers, debt recovery tribunals were established to facilitate the debt recovery involving banks and other financial institutions with their customs. Actually, DRT or debt recovery tribunal were set up after the passing of recovery of debt due to banks and financial institution act, that is RDBBFI 1993. Sections 3 of this particular act empowers the central government to establish DRTS. Appeal against order passed by the DRTS lie before Debt Recovery Appellate Tribunal or DRAT. Now, what are the powers and function of this particular DRT, this tribunal? Number one, the DRT enforces provisions of the recovery of debt due to banks and financial institution, that is RDDBFI Act 1993, and also securitization and reconstruction of financial asset and enforcement of the security interest, that is SARFAESI Act 2000. Second point is that the DRT are fully empowered to pass comprehensive orders and can travel beyond the CPC to render complete justice. A debt recovery tribunal or DRT can hear cross suits, counterclaim, and allow setoffs. Now, third is that, however, a debt recovery tribunal or DRT cannot hear claims of damages or deficiencies of service or breach of contract or criminal negligence on the part of the lenders. In addition, a debt recovery tribunal or DRT cannot express an opinion beyond its domain or the list pending before it. And viewers, number fourth point is that the DRT can appoint receivers, commissioners, pass ex parte orders and interim orders. Interim orders, apart from powers to review its own decision and hear appeals against order passed by the recovery officer of the tribunal. Now, viewers, what are the other important features of the DRT? First is that a DRT is presided over by a presiding officer who is appointed by the central government and who shall be qualified to be a district judge with tenure of 5 years or the age of 62, whichever is earlier. Now, second thing is that no court in this country other than the Supreme Court and High Court, and that too only under Article 226 and 227 of the Constitution, have jurisdiction over the matter. And third point is that the central government in 2018 raised the pecuniary limit from rupees 10 lakh to rupees 20 lakh for filing application for recovery of debt in the debt recovery tribunal by such bank and financial institution. Now, viewers, I am going to another important phase of that particular discussion of that topic, that is the difference between DRT and SARFAESI Act. Actually, the SARFAESI Act 2002 provides stringent powers to the banks and financial institution, whereby the secured asset of the borrower is auctioned without the intervention of the DRT. So, viewers, that is our today's actually discussion. What are the concept of the debt recovery tribunal and what are the powers and function of the particular debt recovery tribunal? Hopefully, you understand the topic. Lastly, actually, I am thankful to all the viewers who actually viewed our channel. Thank you, and thank you to all of you.